Good evening. My name is Germano. I am at the Duke University. It's almost an honorary position because I live in Italy now. I am retired and I will like to speak about blended and nudged Navier-Stokes equation, what it means. Okay, first of all, the motivation. We have today two interesting and in a sense similar topics that are the integration of CFD and FED, and hybrid RANS LES. From a point of view, it means how we can dialogue between different topics and different modeling techniques. The simplest mathematical approach, engineering approach, pragmatic approach, are always being blending and nudging. In a sense, our simple way of mixing is the simple way. And so I will analyze this approach, and then I will speak about blended and nudged Navier-Stokes equation, and now I will show what it means. First of all, motivation. We have computational fluid dynamics, experimental fluid dynamics. An interesting preface about data simulation in fluid dynamics, we found this statement. It's probably fair to assert that AFD and CFD have been independently developed for a long period of time, the last several years, however. More attention has been paid to the integration of AFD and CFD to compensate mutual weaknesses. Then another motivation. We have Reynolds averaged Navier-Stokes equation, RANS. We have large eddy simulation, LES. Also in this case, from the practical point of view, it could be very interesting to couple LES and RANS. It's arguably in an interesting paper about hybrid less RANS, it's arguably the main strategy to drastically reduce computational cost for making LES affordable in a wide range of complex industrial applications. So you see that the motivations are theoretical and practical at the same time. We have a practical motivation in order to reduce the cost. I am speaking obviously of very non-homogeneous flow, not anisotropic flow, or non-homogeneous flow. So in this case, but we have also very interesting theoretical motivation about that. Let us look at the way in which we can analyze the problem. We have the Navier-Stokes equation, okay? LES has been, by Leonard, formalized from the point of view of filtered Navier-Stokes equation. To filter results is very simple. To filter equation is not so simple. I have a lot of friends, mathematicians, that always say, what are you doing, stuff. And so, anyway, I would introduce a linear operators. I will indicate with these symbols the filtered quantities, and I apply this filter to the equation. I filter the Navier-Stokes equation. What happens? It happens that in Navier-Stokes equation we have a lot of new forces. The divergence is not zero, there is a force in the momentum equation, and the main term is that term. It appears in the Reynolds equation, it appears in LES, is a stress, and we have the that is due to the non-linearity of this term. And then we have also two other quantities due to another point that usually the filter does not commute with the derivatives. And if there is no commutation with the derivatives, space derivatives, time derivatives, we have this term indeed. Divergence is not zero, and there is a force induced by the non-commutivity of the filtering operators with derivative and the derivative of the filtering operators. Okay, fortunately, the operators, the most important operators, the LES average, the Leonard average, they are commuting with space and with times. So we have only this term in the equation, and this term is the so-called subgrid stress. The Rance average, I use the Rance average from the point, I assume that there is the ergodic, that the Navier-Stokes are ergodic, obey the ergodic principle, so that the Rance average intended as an infinite time average also is commuting with time and space, so that we have also in this case, this is the famous Reynolds stress. So from this point of view, LES and Rance are the same. It's only a question of scale, because formally they have a term that is a stress, that is induced by the non-linearity of the equation. Let us go on. The procedure for hybrid RANless are the detached eddy simulation, global modeling. There is a lot of way in which, as we have seen in the previous presentation, model, very complex K epsilon model, are modified in order to become zonally LES by introducing the grid as a particular length, significant in length, and so on. I don't enter in all that is so complex and so difficult that really. A very simple way is blending. Blending is a very simple way to blend model. To blend model means, okay, there is the blended Rance LES model is a blended, there is a blending function, K, function of xi and t, and this is the model. And this is a way of managing the coupling of LES and Rance from some zones to another zones. Okay, let us look at this blending formalism from the point of view of filtered the Navier-Stokes equation. It's very interesting, because if we look at the problem from the point of view that it's probably better to introduce a blended filter and to look to the model that is associated to the blended filters, following the idea of Leonard, if we introduce a blended filter H, and we define, obviously, the quantities like that, we have this result. Well, okay, obviously, the stress are always algebraically defined in the same way. This is the Reynolds stress. This is the subgrid stress. This is the hybrid Rance-LES stress, and the result is that. The result is that, okay, the pragmatic blended model is right, but you have another contribution. There is another contribution. This is the model associated to the blended filters. And this contribution is important in order to interface Rance and LES in different regions. And from the point of view, okay, it's always a very pragmatic way of looking at the problem, to blend, but at least I blend filters. And from this point of view, that is a field. Obviously, there are other quantities related to this filter, because this K depends on X and T. But so there are other contributions, as we have seen. But the most important contribution, the contribution due to the stress, the hybrid stress, is like that. So that the hybrid stress is a composition of Reynolds stress, a weighted composition of the Reynolds stress, and there is an. Let us go rapidly to the integration of CFD and FD. Obviously, I only give a very simple consideration. The data assimilation is a topic that you know is so complex, and so there are variational methods, the regression. Interesting, from a point of view, are very interesting the sequential methods. The sequential methods in which you imagine you have a computer that is produced by an experimental facility coupled with a computer, and they dialogue. And they dialogue and they give results, they improve, at least we hope that they improve the simulation. Obviously, it could be the opposite. But anyway, nudging is the typical way in which sequential methods are introduced, I don't know, in meteorological prevision. To nudge, what it means exactly? Nudging, in a sense, is the Newtonian relaxation. It's an idea so old that it is attributed to Newton. And it means, okay, we have this equation. The CFD, AFD nudging algorithm that has been used, is used in some application, is to add this term. And this term is a feedback force driven by the measured velocity field that, in some sense, control the computation by enriching, by driving the computation with what in the, this is the usual, very, this is a very simple way of looking at that, but it was now is used in meteorological simulation. We continue to do computation and we enrich our computation with real data that arrives to the computer by the real data provided by meteorological station. If we look also at nudging from the point of view of the filtered Navier-Stokes equation, we have the same, nudging obviously is intuitive, is easy to implement. It lacks a firm theoretical foundation, like blending. The nudging coefficient is based on pure empiricism. If the nudge coefficient is too strong, the computation is driven so rapidly by the data that it becomes unstable. If it's too little, the effect is it. So there are a lot of problems as exposed in this very interesting paper by Lakshmi Varan and Lewis. But let us look from the point of view of a filtered algorithm. We have a computation and we have an experimental simulation. And we assume that they are solutions of the Navier-Stokes equation. Okay, the hybrid CFD-FD filter can be defined in the same way of the hybrid filter that provides the dialogue between LES and RANS. So that now here I use this these abbreviated symbols, k is a blending factor, function of time, such that at the beginning is one. One means, okay, I have my computation, now I have real data, and I try to introduce this data in order to nudge my computation. And obviously the limit of KT is infinity. What happens? It happens that the filtered equation for the hybrid CFD, FD are given by that. And now we have two terms. We have the first term is that we have as for runs less an hybrid stress. But we have also another term that is due to the fact that my my blending factor K is function of T, so that this filter does not commute with time. And the non-commutivity with time produces now this term here. And it's very interesting because feedback is a feedback blending force. The term is also in this case very similar to the blending. And the coefficient lambda now is directly related to the function k, when t cap is a feedback blending stress given by that. In a sense, it's a non-linear blending stress. This is very new, is not a relaxation, and is due to the non-linearities, obviously. Very rapidly, I conclude. Well, if the blending factor is exponential, we have the same results as usual nudging. If exponential, this value of 1 over k dk dt is equal, lambda b is lambda. And that is the results that I have published recently. So that conclusion. Modified version of the Navier-Stokes equation have been recently proposed, where a nudging term or a blending model has been added. Mind, I have obviously reduced to the minimal form all that. They are very complex, but from the point of view of the impostation of the problem, that is what happens in order to improve dialogue of different techniques, of different theories. The filtered, from the point of view of the filtered Navier-Stokes equation associated to a hybrid blending operator, they are similar as regards the nudging term and the blending model, but differ for the appearance of a forcing stress. And this term could be relevant in the formulation of hybrid runs LES approach and the CFD-FD integration. As usual, the conclusion is that there is a lot of work to do. I am very old, probably. I hope that you young people that are here will be a little interested by all that, all this stuff. Thank you very much for your attention.
Yeah. What we show nudging model is done per point, but it's hard to imagine that either experimentally or hybrid runs is available everywhere in the same quantities.
No.
What I've seen quite successful done when people do nudging based on the mean quantities, for example, that when they nudge mean LES with mean.
Yeah.
And this seems to be much more successful because what happens, this term which you show, commutation term, is because there is a one region where they overlap, and then this term is gone, and then it's kind of more kind of mathematically rigorous assumption because there is a layer where this term is completely negligible. Is that what you're proposing? Or?
There is a lot of work. You are right. Obviously, experiments are many cases you have with particle image velocimetry, you have 2D slides, or you have or you have averaged values and LES. Okay, but this is only the beginning. The idea of managing of debt, all debt, from the point of view of introducing filters. Here I have only imagined that you have really the true are the results from the point, the starting point that I have the true, the model is not so correct, and the hope is that the model can be driven by the truth in order to, that is the fantasy. In many cases I have seen that there is people, particularly in Japan, that are interested in the problem. There is a lot of post-processing in order to improve the dialogue. It's not so simple. The problem of having to couple, to nudge LES and RANS is in a sense easy to do because I introduce more complex filters. And in any case, it's interesting, in my opinion, at least to look at what happens from the point, from the formal point of view, if we introduce filters, which is the model associated to the filter. They give some hints at least in order, but anyway, you are right. It's very complex, the problem of data simulation. I think there is a piece of chalk. No, it's the, we are very. I think the classic way of looking at, if I have understood your question, of joining LES and RANS. Oh, yeah, excuse me.
If you look up there, third point, hybrid RANS, yeah,
yes.
LES approach. And so you're going to improve that. Well, what does that do? Why do analysts use an LES in the outer region and a RANS near the wall?
Okay. Okay. So, two problems. There is a wall, RANS. LES, this is the usual way. So I put my lens here. But another way is, I don't know. Here I have to put the lens. Here, RANS, what there is in a channel, a sudden expansion. So in many cases, we have everything is known from the point of view, but here we have the problem. We have the vortices and so on. So that the way in which the reason why in many cases I have the problem of joining LES and RANS, I don't know, in Stanford now they are they have done an hybrid LES and RANS in which there is a complete turbine and there is the compressor and then the RANS in and the expansion is LES and so on. That is not so intuitive that I have RANS near the wall and LES in the bulk. The first time I spoke about that, people said, why? It's not, it could be the code. No, we have the boundary layer. Now we have a lot of very good RANS models near the wall that manage very well accelerated boundary layers, pressure driven boundary layers. So that, and obviously, LES means the eddies. We have not eddies near the wall. a sense, near the wall, we are not that. So that we are obliged, the near the walls, to use in a, to use Rand's model. But I don't know if I have rightly understood your question.
There was a point where you said, and I'm on your side on it, that LES, I tell my friends at MSU that an LES is just a poor man's Rand's.
Well, that is probably more, it's more than a joke. You are right, it's more than a joke. But what about the NS following
the starting point for RANS is an exact solution that's connected to the Navier-Stokes equation and is an ensemble average. And the LES, that's why I call it a poor man's RAN. They're making up a filter to do something specific. So I agree with you that LES fundamental ideas and thinking and RANS, they go hand in hand. They're the same story with different shirts on or something.
Yes.
But now people are putting them together. And what I'm curious about, what is it that's physically in the LES that's not in the RANS that is doesn't, it needs to, you need to have an LES in the outer region and vice versa? From a physical point of view, not, what, I know you
No, no, from the physical point of view, I mean, in the last, in my activity, I published a paper in which I was very proud about the filtering invariance. The equation are the same. The equation don't know that you are filtering with a Rand's operator or with a LES operator. The problem was due to the fact that at first people was using the fluctuation. Also that the fluctuations are very easy and very nice for statistical fluctuation because the mean of the statistical fluctuation is zero. But the mean of the LES fluctuation is not zero. So that is better to introduce formally the subgrid stress as you are right. I think, and today it's not so long. Now you don't see paper in which they speak of LES fluctuation. At least that is a good improvement in my opinion. So the stresses are defined like that, and all that, and also the triple correlation. Are defined algebraically. If you define algebraically the moments, they are the same from the algebraic. So that the difference is in how you model, as you exposed this morning, how you model the problem of I beg your pardon, you were speaking this morning about the fundamental quality of a model, that is the
realizable,
but not only realizable, the invariance, the framework, it applies to LES, it applies to the Leonard filter.
Do you think that
so model, in the model you have the length, you have all that, but from the formal point of view, the equation is the same, excuse me.
Subgrid model with a model that had more physical ideas in it, that you wouldn't have to combine the RANS and LES when you go into the wall.
Yes, I think so. Global modeling.
Isn't the subgrid model that prevents going into the wall?
No.
What is it?
Boundary conditions. Because if you take no slip conditions, which actually makes it Navier-Stokes. Makes the resolution requirement almost a DNS, which defeats LES.
Yeah, but that is a practical point of view.
That's why people they want LES away from the world.
So what boundary conditions are used?
But from the theoretical point of view, you could. Global modeling.
I think they're doing hybrids because it's cheaper.
Well, there you go.
ideally they want to do LES.
But they're using hybrids, and then but you're solving maybe a very narrow class of flows, and you can use it to do interpolation, not predictions. So is there any future in CFD?
Probably.
Excuse me. The fundamental is that in the runs, you forgot the structure. In the LES, there are the structure. So they are completely two different things.
Oh, they have different.
So the energy spectra, that is the building things in turbulence, is forgotten in the runs. So it's something else.
Yeah.
That's it.
And also the scale, if you do LES close to the wall, it's no longer mostly boundary conditions. And how if you can give a good model for boundary conditions, you don't need runs, period. But no boy, I mean, that's the whole issue.
Yeah. So I had a practical.
If you can do the whole boundary.
Typically,
if you know how
we
do
LES,
you don't need.
And many times the grid is the filter.
So you're talking about a solid.
You have an adaptive mesh refinery.
But I think it's a.
So then you go something like Specialis and Phasos blend. I'm trying to play with myself now. And they have this magic contribution function that mixes the turbulence model with the LES.
Yes, I know very well the paper by Speziale.
It's kind of a phenomenological function they've used. I mean, some Speziale started using
yes.
it. Everybody keeps doing their own.
The famous paper on the IAAA paper. And
So basically, you have two pieces of art there. You have the adaptive mesh refinement, which is usually totally ad hoc. It's based on whatever you think is important.